We were on land that time forgot. So let's get started. Just a little bit more. Oh, this is interesting. Reminds me of Serious Sam in a way. Get out there. Hi, Bone. I hope you're doing well today. Oh. Maybe I should pay attention. Actually starting out quite dark. Oh wow. Where is... it would be right here. Need a blue skull for that. I got it right off the bat now. I definitely gotta say, this mod is really good for atmosphere. Bar none. I haven't seen only Winter's Fury. Now, actually, Unloved was very ambient as well. I have to give that one props. So I'd say it's up there on their levels. Oh. That genuinely scared me. I didn't. Those slug things are now, invisible. I don't know why I picked that up. Nice that I'm gonna have to deal with them now, so I guess I shouldn't be surprised. After all, they're pretty much the pinky equivalent. They can't hurt you unless they're right up on you, eating your face. This is really the ending already. I know this is the first level, but shit. This is pretty goddamn short. Alright, let me see. Let me figure out what else I can do in this level, because there's two secrets and one more monster. I don't think there's any way of getting out here. I don't really think there is anything out there either. Didn't even give you any weapons. There's probably weapons in one of the secrets. Not that this thing's bad, though. That's definitely one of them. There's actually quite a few things that I want to get to as well. This is probably the second secret. I kind of knew before that there were Link to the Past mods, but... or ROM hacks. I actually want to try some of those out. One's done by a speedrunner, I found out. Like, actually physically made, not that he speedran it. Super Scudge, I believe. And there's like a few more that are actually... that have actually been pretty well received. So I actually want to try those. This person did a really good job, I guess, hiding these secrets. Because I really don't have any clue where to find them. Like, nothing stands out. I can't really do anything about that. Spend too much longer looking for this. But yeah, I'm either really blind or he did a really good job trying to find this. Could be one in here, because it's really dark. But I know for a fact that's an exit. Nothing on the map really screams out secret either. Like, there's no real hint. Like, maybe that one wall, but that's it. No. Well, I'm all done trying to look for it. Some of them I've been able to find, others... this guy lost me. See, there's a hole right there. Like on this, I don't hear anything either. So I'm actually kind of wondering if there's a way to go in there through the hole, but I don't think there is. Yep, that's the ending. Alright. Oh, hey, here's a shotgun. No, it's a assault rifle. Almost looked like a shotgun. But I actually have not gotten a shotgun yet. Oh, shit. Are they launched more than just the one set? I think they're basically the Hell Knight equivalent. I've seen a different version of them in Ultimate Torment and Torture. Spiders. And I got my face blown off. This one kind of seems like it's stepping up its difficulty a little bit in comparison to the previous ones. We need to get rid of them fast. This is going to require some saving. Anyone who has arachnophobia, sorry in advance. I've encountered them too, I think also in Ultimate Torment. Oh. Dude, these guys respawn. Seems like they only die for a certain amount of time. That's gonna be unpleasant. Seems like it's two of them, though. The level design in this one's really, really neat. I think I like it a lot better than any of the other ones I've seen. I don't know. I kind of like the first levels a little bit better because... But that's just because of how they look. Floating villages. That was actually like a really good concept. I just like that the whole sense of the void as a whole. It's terrifying to think out, but it's a really think about, but it's a really cool concept. This mod didn't have to say that it was Lovecraft inspired. It's just showing it in spades. Oh, there we are. I was wondering where. God, I killed these guys. I'm kind of glad that there's a lot of newer mods that are out that kind of ditch hit scan entirely for enemy based weapons. Just make it projectile based. Granted, like, Brutal Doom does that especially. Everything's projectile-based. With the exception of your own weapons, I think. I think some of them are still... Some of your own weapons, I think, are still hit-scan. They kind of need to do that because... just because of how the newer mods are running. He's definitely making a little bit more. You gotta be a little more careful in this one. Definitely. That was something Heretic tried way back on, too. Most of the weapons and attacks are projectiles. That makes sense. Like, outside of Wolfenstein, like, Doom was, like, the first. As far as... like, you had first-person games... I don't know if Daggerfall came. The Elder Scrolls Daggerfall. I'm not sure when that came. I'm not sure if that was before or after Doom. But you had games like that. Like, even before Doom. That were first-person, but they weren't... the way that they did things for this game was... unique for its time. And the hit scan is not entirely, it's not entirely age well. But it's good that the source ports allow you to get around and still not like break the game and make it like too much or too little. Either yours or the enemy's favor. Literally all you can make me going because I have very good lag. Okay, you die outright. Oh! I forgot I got it. Alright. I think the reason why they can make it work too is because they can determine the value for how fast projectile-based weapons fire. So, like, if you want to make all of your guns projectile-based, you can make it work. It won't just fire as fast as the rocket launcher, which is actually really slow. Why? Because those things fuck you up. I have, like, no ammo for anything. There's three secrets in this map, too. I think there's one right there. I just need to find it, too. Hmm. He's got to keep those things away from him. Oh! Wait, he was still alive. That's, it doesn't seem like they can get up here anyway. Let me see. Nah, it doesn't look like it. Alright, they'll let me out here. There we go. Alright, now I don't feel so, ill-prepared. I think this might, it might be good to still kind of use this thing. This is basically the replacement for the chainsaw, but it actually has a range to it. I haven't even found the exit yet. Oh. They kind of revealed to this revealed this to me on the map. Oh, there we go. I like this thing. Those things are scary because what they throw is poisonous. It'll not only hurt you, but also give you damage over time. I think that's it. I did find one secret. There's another one. There's still one more relevant enemy. Heretic, there's... Oh, that's the cross... That's a cross... That crossbow is from Heretic. I'm not surprised. Considering the theme of this game. I did not even know that there was ammo. It almost seems like I could get back there. Oh. Yeah, there we are. Seems like a bigger spider. Kinda needed that toe because it has health in here. Hey Azu. Just retro payday, this is far from payday as I think you can get. We be fighting demons, not cops. Hi, Cece. And that emote always looks so cool. My red skull and stuff. Fuck that. Guys are like flies. I don't see anything else. I feel like that's definitely has to be the third secret. I just don't know how to get up there. There's a teleport somewhere, and it's not that one that I saw before. Yeah, I'm not. This is definitely not a. This can't be original music. It's too. If it is, I mean, I am very impressed. But this is probably from like a video game or something. Like a different video game. We'll just end the level. Found two of them, so we're good. Yeah, this mod's HP Lovecraft inspired, so it's definitely gonna have a lot of spooky music. I hope you don't have a fear of spiders either, because now we're starting to see them in this level. Wow, this is there's a lot of water in this. God damn it. God damn it! How the hell? Oh god. I hate those things. Jesus. Hey, Joel. They're all dead now. Those things scare the crap out of me when I don't see them in the water and all of a sudden their attack animation pops up. I don't know what it is about them in particular. Like a big fucking map though, at least starting out. I think the Serious Sam feeling, though, is unintentional. I'm gonna save right here. Replaying a bullet. It can get that way with a lot of different Doom mods because of all the projectiles. Until I start getting caught with some bigger mobs. Oh! How much do I have in this? I don't know where you came from. Alright, there's a spider cave right there. I kinda just needed that for the health. I don't really care about the berserkness. Caves are very Duke Nukem-ish. I found a Megaton Edition version of it, and I want to stream that at some point. Because I only ever played the first episode and the first few levels of the first episode of Duke Nukem. I actually want to play the whole thing. Got that instead of the version that's on Steam because Gearbox replaced the previous version. They got rid of that old version and put in their version, which I don't like the fact that they replaced Sonic's lines. So, the Megaton version is the only working version that I could find. Outside of that. You kind of tolerate episode 2. The level design kind of takes a hit there. I'm not surprised. Like, most people who like Duke Nukem like Doom, but I more so hear praise about Doom's level design than so Duke Nukem's. The engine's actually different, though. I actually thought that they shared the same engine. But they actually don't, and it's because I didn't realize how verticality wasn't a thing for Doom, like having multiple floors. People have since found a way to get around that. Nukem allows you to develop levels that have different floors to them. I mean, you can develop like vertical-like levels in Doom, but you can only go a certain height. So if you want to develop like different types of floors for levels, you kind of have to do a fake teleportation. Like a fake teleportation type of thing, where when you reach the next floor, it's actually like a teleport, but it doesn't, like, I saw it in that Christmas Doom mod that I made. My god, I can't think straight. I swear I did not make that mod. Just Fear made that mod. I'm not claiming that I made that mod. I don't know why I said that.
Thank you.
Yeah, not mod on real levels. Like, you actually notice, too, a little bit, that when you go up to the second floor, it's actually a teleport, not an actual floor. Tried to make it as seamless as possible, but it's a little noticeable. I think I have enough ammo to spare. Do a lot of silent teleporting to get things done in the official levels.
Oh, really?
Actually, didn't know that, but I still think it's a different engine. Because whenever I've seen, like, makings of for, like, Duke Nukem 3D, because I think Doom was the first iteration of the id Tech engine. Like, Doom 2016 is, like, id Tech level 6 or 5, I forget. But Duke Nukem does not use id Tech. And if they did, they probably licensed to use and modify it and made it their own. But I'm pretty sure they didn't. I'm pretty sure they just developed their own engine. It probably just works in a very similar way. I mean, it does... It is reminiscent of Doom, and people have, like, ported over... like, the Duke Nukem weapons. Like, they were in realism, and they're in Russian Overkill as well. Duke is the build engine. Oh, okay. Yeah, that's what I heard. I still haven't killed these guys yet. They're gonna spawn a bunch of spiders in this one in particular. Oh no, I was wrong. They were gonna spawn enemies, but it's just a bunch of things. Again, it feels like it is. Oh, turn auto aim off. Oh, it screws me up. It was created for Ken's Labyrinth, which was a clone of Wolfenstein 3D. That piece I actually didn't know. Mm-hmm. Oh, we need this. Actually get up this way. Damn it. Did I not have enough speed, or can I just not make that shit gap? Oh, I didn't have enough speed. Alright. I won't have enough speed for that. There we go. Neat. I like that one. Where should I be going next? But yeah, that, like, thinking about it, I would love to just start playing like a lot of different ROM hacks. Actually, like, back in the day, I used to play, show off this one ROM hack on my YouTube channel called Mushroom Kingdom Fusion. I actually ended up getting quite a few views on those. They were like silent playthroughs, they're not like this. Oh yeah, I want to go in that hole. So, I don't think I'll go back to playing that game, because that fan game is pretty much dead at this point. What did that do? That's a secret, but did it open anything? But people made Dead Forever. Unless somebody decides to salvage the resources from it. Like, there was multiple attempts to try and finish that project, because I followed it. I was one of the people that used to always upload a bunch of playthroughs of the different levels that they made. But it was just like one big hot mess. And it had no direction, and that's why I ended up dying after a while. But I would like to get back to doing something like that. Like, I already kind of am doing it. I'm playing a bunch of different mods, like, full-fledged campaigns for Doom. I want to see if I can find some of these Link to the Past ROM hacks that I found, or that I've been looking at. Okay, this is an arena. Without a doubt. Oh god. I came out of nowhere, sorry about that. So, what am I doing here? Oh, there we go. I was wondering when they would activate. Oh. God, I almost killed myself. I felt like for a while that I was the only person that knew that that word existed. Nobody ever uses it. It basically means God bless you in German, doesn't it? I never heard a single person use it but, like, me and whoever was in my family. Oh, that's what it stands for? Wishing you good health? Seriously? That's all this did. That can't be all this. It just brought the exit up. Okay. Gondola Grotto. I fired by accident. Now I just alerted the horde. It's not much of a horde. I swear that looks like a secret door, but I guess not. Oh, that's why. Just a ball texture. I love that Nothing More song stuck in my head. Not a bad thing. I like that song. So I wonder if requested in Claude's chat while he was playing Darkest Dungeon. They're a really good band. I really should get another. Maybe not their latest one. Maybe I should get the latest one. There's two songs of theirs that I know. Jenny and Go to War. Both of them are really good. They got a really good, like, ambient kind of sound to them. If that makes any sense. To anyone that might be new, I love my rock music. There is good modern rock music out there, you just gotta keep your mind open a little. I feel like because rock's no longer mainstream anymore, they're allowed to be a little more creative with their concept, because they're not trying to appeal to a mass demographic. They're just trying to share music that they want to play. That's kind of what I like about the state of rock music nowadays. You still get those people, you still get those, like, Nickelback equivalents that... I hate to say it, but, like, Nickelback isn't, like, 100% shit. They put out, like, maybe one or two songs that are alright. In my opinion. In my opinion. But, you still get bands like that, but I feel like the majority try their best to be unique and just try to make music that they want to play, as opposed to what they think. What they think their record label would want. I'm genuinely stuck right now. There's a switch and I have not found it yet. When followed, reported to AOL. Yeah, you just gotta wait until your connection goes in with that 56k modem. What the fuck do I do on this map? God, I do not miss those days. Like, I remember, like, way back, I was trying to load, like, an advertisement for Beavis and Butthead Do America, because at that time, I really liked them, and I didn't get to watch them too often, because they were always on too late at night, past my bedtime. So, I wanted to watch this little, like, advertisement they had for the movie. It was like a 3-minute advertisement, and it took like over 2 hours to load it entirely. I kept watching like the first 30 seconds. It was a QuickTime movie, too. What the fuck do I do on this map? Not the exit either, it's just to go to the next part. I wish Bane would give me an idea at this point. Of course, the first thing he'd probably say is caustic soda. No, Bane, I'm stuck in a cave. I'm not trying to make meth. Need to cut through solid rock. What the fuck do I do on this map? I'm gonna feel so stupid when I actually find out what the damn solution is. Get stuck here. Mm. You can't shoot switches. That's why I keep shooting the walls. You actually weren't... That was actually a good suggestion. Unfortunately, it just didn't work. I'm fucking stuck right now. You can't open it just by hitting the use key. That also doesn't do anything. I almost feel like I broke the level somehow. What's the name of the Gondola Grotto? Alright, the name of the map didn't help me either. Yeah, I genuinely feel like I broke the map somehow. Map could have bugged for all I know. Oh, let me see. It's called Strange Aeons Gondola Grotto. I mean, Winter's Fury had a few bugs with it. I wouldn't be surprised if there was one here. Okay, this didn't help me. This is just a Tumblr post about it. So three, there we are. Damn it. DoomWiki doesn't have anything. There's someone using a Project Uber mod with, while playing Strange Aeons as well, so let me see how he solves this map. Let's see, where is he at? I didn't do this map yet, so that's too far ahead. Alright, this was the previous map I was on. Seems like he's playing this with Uber Mini. Oh, okay. So it seems like a HUD mod and he's using a special weapon. Seems like he's having the same trouble as me figuring out how to get out of this room. What? I tried all four of the pillars, though. That's weird. Maybe I didn't. Try this pillar. Now, I don't attribute that to a problem with the map, because there's one thing I just noticed about that. I attribute that to just me being really fucking blind. Out of all four of those pillars, the one that I activated had a crack in it, and it wasn't subtle either. So I'm just fucking blind. I don't know why he was playing that with a Brutal Doom mod. I mean, I guess I could see. I think that would make this a little too easy. This is not really that hard of a mod. These things are basically lost souls, they just don't explode on impact. Actually, in the original, I'm thinking of Doom 2016, in the original. The designs on a lot of these monsters. Like I said, I've always loved the style of Lovecraftian style. I gotta make another attempt of reading Call of Cthulhu. Like, his style of writing, it's really hard for me to get into. It's abstract. Not nearly as annoying as Shakespeare, but... It's enduring because of the type of language that he uses. And I'm not that much of a reader. Call of Cthulhu, Dark Corners of the Earth. I know there's a bunch of first-person games. Oh, there's a new one coming out, too, that actually looks interesting. There's a bunch of different Cthulhu type games and different styles. There's a point and click one too. Eldritch 24-hour stream when I have enough material for it. They take a lot away, holy shit. It's still there. God, they make my skin crawl just because they can come from any direction. They move so fast. Definitely doing its job.